Hello and welcome friends. We are studying index number in statistics, and in the last lecture we discussed about fixed base method of finding index numbers. Let's take an example on fixed base method before going to study the chain base method. In this example we have data from the year 2013 to 2020, but mind well, 2020 is not over. These are the years ending 31st March, that means 31st March 13, 14, 15 and 31st March 20. Okay, these are the profit figures in 10,000. 275 means 27,50,000 or 2.75 million. Okay. And since we need to calculate the index numbers by fixed base method, we have been asked to take 2013 as base year. That means for calculating index numbers for all these years, the base year will be fixed 2013. Okay, and now we know that the formula to calculate index number for profit is profit for current year divided by profit for base year whole into 100 to get the percentage. Yes, okay, now let's calculate. For the year 2013, the value or profit for current year is 275 and profit for the base year is also 275, so the ratio comes to 1. It always happens with the base year. Index number for base year is always 100. Okay, now 2014 becomes current year. Base year remains 2013 because fixed base method. So it will be now 284 profit for current year divided by 275 profit for base year 2013 into 100. Yes, see, the profit has marginally increased from 275 to 284 and index number comes to 103.27. Please keep two decimal places. Yes, so in 2014 the profit increased by 3.27% as compared to 2013. This can be the conclusion on the basis of this index number. If profit we made in 2013 was 100, in 2014 is 103.27. Okay, let's calculate for 2015. Profit for 2015, current year, 289 divided by profit for base year 275 divided by 200. Yes, again a marginal increase is there, 105.09. Yes, so we can say that in 2015 profit increased by 5.09% as compared to 2013. 2016 profit is 293 divided by 275, the profit for base year 2013 whole in 200. See, the profit increases marginally every year, but it increased. The important thing is profit increases every year, 106.55. So in 2016 profit increased by 6.55% as compared to the profit made in 2013. Yes, in 2017 it is 297 divided by 275 into 100, that means it is approximately 108. Yes, in 2017 profit increased by 8% as compared to the profit we made in 2013. In 2018, what is the situation? 313 divided by 275. We are dividing all values by 275 every year because we follow the fixed base method of calculating index number, and our fixed base year is 2013 for the whole data. Yes, 213 divided by 275 into 100. The index number comes to 113.82 approximately. So in the year 2018 profit increased by 13.82% as compared to 2013. Yes, in 2019 what happens? 328 divided by 275 whole into 100. Okay, the rate of increasing the profit has decreased. It comes to 119.27. And for the last year of our data, 2020, it is 245 divided by 275 into 100. Yes, it comes to 125.45. 125.45. Okay, yeah, okay. So, in the year 2020, the profit increased by 25.45% as compared to profit made in 2013. So, this was discussion about fixed base method. In this lecture and in the previous lecture, we discussed about fixed base method. That in this case, in case of fixed base method, the base year remains fixed for the whole data, for the whole time series. Yes. Now, we share and the discussion or special discussion on fixed base method here in this lecture. I hope all these lectures on index number are proving very useful to you in understanding the concepts, in understanding the calculations. Don't forget to like this lecture, to subscribe my channel, as well as to suggest my lectures and channel to all your friends, classmates, or whoever in contact with you. That's it. Thank you very much.